Three life sentences in exchange for the three lives he took 5 years ago. Cassandrins Blanc will spend the rest of his days behind bars for killing his pregnant wife, Martine Bernard, and her father, Roosevelt Bernard Sr., and then trying to hide their bodies back in June of 2018.
This is Love Hurts. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit that notification bell for future content. 20-year-old Martine Bernard was described by family as loving, charismatic, family-oriented, and overall just a fun person to be around. She was a newlywed. She had married 22-year-old Cassandrins Blanc in Hollywood, Florida on October 4th of 2017. The two quickly became pregnant and by all accounts seemed to be excited about their new bundle of joy. But as we all know, things are not always what they appear. And although Martine's family thought Cassandrins was a great guy, he was battling some serious demons inside, and those demons were about to be put on full display. On June 4th of 2018, after an argument, Cassandrins shot and killed his wife Martine, who was 6 months pregnant with the couple's first child. And this was just the beginning of his sick and twisted ways. After sitting at home with his wife's deceased body for 5 days, Cassandrins dropped by his in-laws' home on June 9th. According to Martine's mom, her and her husband were getting ready to attend a family function. Cassandrins told her he needed to pick up some clothes for Martine that she had left behind. The couple welcomed their son-in-law into their home, not realizing that he had just killed their daughter 5 days prior. The Bernards were so unsuspecting. Miss Bernard went to shower and continue getting ready for the family event that she had to attend, leaving her husband alone with Cassandrins. While she showered, Mr. Bernard was lured into his daughter's old bedroom, and once he got there, Cassandrins put a bullet in the back of his head. Cassandrins then began trying to cover his tracks. When his mother-in-law emerged from the shower and began asking questions about her husband's whereabouts, he told her that a Hispanic man had dropped by the house and that her husband went to go speak with him. She did notice that her daughter's bedroom door was locked, and she also noticed that Cassandrins was wearing gloves, but she was running late for her event, so believing her husband would just join her later, she began leaving the home. On the way out, Cassandrins told her he had forgot something in the kitchen and needed to return to the home. So she allowed him back in. At that point, police say he unlocked the door so he could return later and dispose of Mr. Bernard's body. According to police, when he returned, he placed Mr. Bernard's body in a city-issued trash can and wheeled it into a vacant field where he dumped the body in the bushes. He then returned the next morning and set Mr. Bernard on fire. Once Mr. Bernard's lifeless body was found, police did automatically suspect Cassandrins because he was the last person to see Mr. Bernard alive, so they began a 24-hour surveillance on him. On June 11th, they witnessed him disposing of a large rubber bin in a dumpster behind his home. When police confiscated the bin, they located the partially dismembered body of his pregnant wife, Martine Bernard. Obviously, Cassandrins was immediately arrested and charged with triple murder.
The Broward man accused of murdering his pregnant wife and her father is now facing additional charges.
And we are learning some disturbing new details about how the victims died. Local 10's Carlos Suarez is live with that new information. Carlos.
In both cases, the police department say that he used a trash can to try to remove both of these bodies from the homes, including the one right behind me. And in one case, a neighbor's camera captures him in the grassy area where one of those bodies was found.
Sir, you're charged with premeditated murder.
22-year-old Cassandrins Blanc was back in court on Thursday to face charges that he murdered his father-in-law and set the body on fire to get rid of it. In court, his attorney underscored the seriousness of the charges by stressing that he not talked to anyone about the case.
Do you understand, sir?
Yes, sir.
According to an arrest warrant, police said Blanc shot 68-year-old Roosevelt Bernard over the weekend after following him into a bedroom at the family home in Hollywood. Police said Bernard's wife was showering at the time. She later told detectives that, quote, she noticed Cassandrins was wearing gloves and that the door to Martine's old bedroom was locked. Detectives said a neighbor's surveillance camera captured Blanc in a grassy area where Bernard's burned body was found earlier this week. The video reportedly shows him with a backpack and wearing black gloves.
What were you able to see?
Well, we don't, like, you know, we just were able to see, like, somebody, like, around when the smoke, come. But after that, they say we can't turn anything else.
The new charges came a day after Blanc was charged with murdering his pregnant wife, 20-year-old Martine Bernard, because she, quote, disrespected him. Police said he used a trash can to try to get rid of the body from their Fort Lauderdale apartment.
Detectives said that Blanc kept the body inside one of the rooms here until the family left for a party and that he came back to get it. They also said that the surveillance video shows Blanc rolling this trash can up the street here. Now, just a few minutes ago, we were able to catch up with two of the brothers out here who said they are still trying to make sense of it all.
We're in shock. You know, we're still trying to fathom, you know, how could this happen to us and why we didn't see it coming, you know. The man, he was a good person, in which we thought at first, you know.
The brothers went on to say that they don't know why Blanc went after their dad, and they did not know exactly what he meant by when he told detectives that his wife had disrespected him. The family is still very much in mourning, and they're still trying to figure out how they're going to cover the costs for both funerals.
Originally, he tried to deny the murder, stating that Martine had killed her father and then killed herself. But after speaking with him for a few hours, police were able to get him to crack. He still never had any reason for killing Mr. Bernard, but he did say that he killed Martine because she had disrespected him.
She basically was like, you know, I did it, you know.
And did what?
Like, she was responsible for her dad's death.
Okay.
Accused killer Cassandra Blanc speaking to a detective, telling him how his pregnant wife, Martine Bernard, shot and killed her own father, Roosevelt Bernard, then had plans on killing herself.
In the text message, she said that she wanted to kill herself. Mm-hmm. And after she died, she wanted to be burned.
That story began to unravel.
I can tell you how. You're ready to let it go. Just let it go. What happened? Cassandra, what happened? How come?
Blanc breaks down crying during the interrogation. Police say he's the one who murdered his wife in their Fort Lauderdale apartment, shooting her in the head, then lived with her decaying body in the apartment before trying to cut up her remains. Police already suspected him, so they were surveilling him and said they saw him wheeling out a trash can containing her body.
My life is done.
Where did it happen? Just let it go. Let it out while you're doing it. Just let it go.
Why are you doing this?
Police say he confessed. The state attorney's office did not release video of his statement, but we know from police reports he allegedly confessed to his wife's murder, saying he killed Martine Bernard because she disrespected him. Police say he also gave details of his father-in-law's murder. Blanc entered a not guilty plea in this case. His attorneys are challenging the legality of that confession. Meanwhile, if convicted, he could face the death penalty.
Well, loved ones of the victims in a triple murder speaking about the sentence handed down for the man convicted of killing them.
It is the outcome of a horrific crime that happened 5 years ago.
That's right. Marissa Back, she was live in the courtroom today as the judge handed down that sentence. She is live in Fort Lauderdale with more. Marissa.
Well, Jawan, even the judge offered his condolences to the family today, knowing what they have been through in recent years. He said that he hopes they find some sort of resolution in today's sentencing. Meanwhile, the killer stood up in court today and apologized to the family for what he did.
Three
life sentences in exchange for the three lives he took 5 years ago. Cassandrance Blanc will spend the rest of his days behind bars for killing his pregnant wife, Martine Bernard, and her father, Roosevelt Bernard Sr., and then trying to hide their bodies back in June of 2018. The Bernard family sat in court to witness justice in hopes of moving on.
I would say I feel more relieved that the situation is over and how justice was served. Our family can finally have a sense of peace
The horror played out over several days. First, Martine went missing. Then Roosevelt Sr. was found shot to death, his body burned and left in a field. Then Martine was found in a dumpster behind the Fort Lauderdale home she shared with Blanc. Still grappling with how he lost his dad, his sister, and her unborn child in a matter of days, Roosevelt Jr. shared how special they were to him.
Very charismatic. She always knew how to get everyone talking, make us laugh. Very fun to be around. He was my hero. Just looking up to him. Just the things that he did, all the things that he overcame. Just a great person, a really big role model for our family. That's where we got our values and our morality from, you know. He really led the family well.
I sincerely would like to apologize.
Blanc stood up in court and addressed his surviving in-laws. As he apologized for his devastating actions, they chose to look away.
No matter what you feel now, it doesn't change the hurt and the pain that we've gone through.
So this was initially a capital murder case. So if it had gone to trial, Blanc faced the possibility of the death penalty if he had been convicted. So his guilty plea meant instead he would get these three life sentences without the possibility of parole. Reporting live in downtown Fort Lauderdale, Marissa Begg, NBC 6 News.
This case is just sick on so many different levels. All I can say is mental health is real. Cassandra clearly had been battling some serious mental health issues. To do something this sick and crazy, you got to be going through something mentally. My heart goes out to Martine's family. This is just truly a very tragic story. If you are experiencing domestic violence in your relationship, please get out. Use the quickest, safest way possible and do not turn back. Turning back can cost you your life. As always, stay safe, loves, and don't forget to subscribe, thumbs up, and hit that notification bell.